What do you think of DC Rogan interview? I remember thinking it was a little messed up, but you know, Joe Rogan interviews so many fighters. I think it's just a habit to. I think of like a fight like that, like more so just wanting to interview him. I think he poured salt on the wound a little bit by saying, "I usually don't interview people after getting knocked out." So I didn't agree with that, especially because it's very emotional for fighters. I didn't like how DC pushed away and snubbed Big John. Big John is awesome, but you know, it is what it is. Fighters get emotional. You can't really fault fighters for acting emotionally after a fight, you know.
Oh my gosh, man. It's a tough situation. Also, you know, Joe has worked with Daniel. He's friendly with Daniel Cormier. Daniel was right there, and things are kind of hectic. And you see that DC's kind of hanging around, and you go, well, maybe he's got something to say. Let me get his thoughts on it. And yeah, I mean, I don't blame Joe Rogan for it. I don't blame you for interviewing Rich Franklin. I think that it's something that you kind of have to make a mistake, or I don't even think it was a mistake necessarily, but it's something you learn from. That's it. And you adjust. I don't think that you had any ill will or Joe had any ill will in interviewing DC. And things are hectic after a fight. There's a lot going on. There's a lot, you know, a lot of people talking in your ear when you got that IFB in. And I think it was a little hectic, and obviously DC was extremely emotional. Obviously he had just suffered a knockout loss, and it was very tough to watch. And more than anything else, man, what I want to talk about are the disgusting people on social media who decide that, you know, this is a funny thing to talk about, and they put out memes and they decide to kick a person when they're down at their absolute worst, that someone decides to make fun of, first of all, a man for crying, but make fun of one of the best fighters that we've ever seen in the octagon, and just lost to the greatest fighter that we've ever seen, and make fun of that person. It's everything that's wrong with the society, and I just found it completely disgusting. And I don't even feel bad for DC. I feel bad for those people that have never accomplished anything or don't know what it's like to work your fucking ass off for something. Because those are the kind of people that are making the memes and making fun of someone like Daniel Cormier.
He was crushed both physically and mentally. And I know Joe Rogan has apologized for interviewing him after the fight. Boss, you and I have talked about the fact. In combat sports, the loser who's been knocked out should not be interviewed, period.
That's it. Yep.
Doesn't matter if it's MMA, boxing, kickboxing. It's unnecessary. So anyway, he apologizes. And then what a class act Daniel Cormier is to go to Instagram, congratulate John Jones and apologize where he didn't need to apologize. And Big John McCarthy said so much when he apologized to Big John for pushing him away when he was concussed, not knowing where he was.
So I felt terrible. And, you know, look, Rogan interviewed him. Rogan said he would not interview fighters. And I believe Joe, and I believe his explanation. I just got caught up in the moment. I saw him there and I ran over to ask him. That Joe loves fighters. He loves Daniel Cormier. He just ran over and he apologized profusely for it. He realized he thought he made a mistake. But it wasn't done. I don't think it was done to be exploitive. It wasn't done out of disregard for DC. He loves DC. It was just one of those dumb things you do in a moment.
Yeah, Joe's a good dude, man.
And there's all these memes going on. It's funny. A fan got mad at me on Twitter.
Why?
Because I liked one of the crying memes. Like, I really did get choked up watching it, and I felt terrible.
Yeah.
And I hated that people were saying mean shit to Cormier on Twitter. Like, mean, like, yeah, fuck him. He's craha. Like,
they did that?
Like that he lost.
And ask me again why I'm not on Twitter.
But the memes, like there's a famous one of Jordan, you know, Michael, oh my God, the fucking third baseman from Mike Schmidt.
Yeah.
From the Phillies, the crying, like sports crying. And there's a picture of him crying, and some of the memes were funny, but they weren't nasty. There was one of him crying. It was like when your older brother has two ice pops and you have one. It was just silly.
Yeah, that's like, funny. All right, that's a funny one.
That's something DC will look back at and go, all right, that was okay.
Right.
I didn't like mean shit or stuff that was hurtful because I love the guy. But someone's like, you, what kind of fan are you? I'm like, what?
Well, listen,
I love the guy.
There's pricks out there. I mean, there's just, listen, there's people like that are just are miserable. What I find a lot with the haters and people like that, or when somebody fails and people get happy, that's the weirdest thing.
Yeah.
It's a projection. It's usually it goes back to their own lives and what they're unhappy. So, oh, look, this guy's unhappy. Oh, good. Be miserable like the rest of us.